Okay, welcome back to my new GN4 tutorial. Last time I showed how you can create a sensitive detector, which you can add then you to your detector construction and then give out the information related to what particle has been detected, where the particle was detected and so on. So we created this grid of photosensors, which basically detect our optical photons. And then I showed how to give this out in a terminal. Yeah? And then you could, of course, dump this into a text file and then use this for further analysis. But I guess this method is not so nice. So now I want to show you a method how you can store these hits, the detected hits, in a separate dedicated root file in a structured form. Yeah? So in the way of n tuples or trees, basically. And then later you can use root to analyze it. And for that, in order to do that, we first have to write, as usual, a new class. This we will call, in this case, my run action. And it's derived from the class G4 user run action. Yeah? And why we will do this, I will explain in a few minutes. So we have to write, we call the files maybe run.cc and run.hh. Now we can write in the header file as usual, if not defined, run.hh, define run.hh, and if. And here we have to include the header file, as I said, g4 user run action.hh. We have to define here our class, which I said we call my run action. This should be publicly inherited from g4 user run action. And we have to, as usual, we have to declare some publics, which is of course the constructor, my run action. This is the destructor, my run action. And then we have to take from this predefined class two functions, which are then of course again virtual functions. And these are called, these are void functions. And these are called begin of run action. And they have to take as an input parameter, as an as an argument, basically g4 run, and the same we can do here, end of run action const g4 run. Okay, so this should be everything. Now the header file is basically done, and now we can include in our C file our header file and define our constructor my run action, and of course we can copy paste that. Yeah, and now we have to basically then go to our functions that we want to use, and this is begin run action and end of run action, and the same here. Okay, so now we have inserted them into our C file, and now we can go to our build folder, and now we created two new files. So we have to write again as usual C make, and then we can build it. And as you can see, there are error messages because I think I should pay some money for that mistake. As usual, I did a mistake here. And as you can see, I did another one which is related. Yeah, here in the header file, I have to write, of course, with capital O, end of run action. Okay, so this is the same. Now we can make it and it works perfectly. So we can start our program. We can run it to see whether it still works, and there's no crash so far. So I also recommend that whenever you do some changes, always compile the program, run it, and see whether it's working. It's a kind of a test scenario, which is a little bit manual, but it works basically. Okay, so currently this is just the frame that we created here, and now we want to fill that. We have to first think, whenever we write a program, what information we want to store in our output file. And and before we do that, we should think where the output file should be created. So we can create it either here in the constructor, then it will be created as soon as you run the program. But we want maybe that it is created new for every run. So every time when you create events, then for that run, which includes these events, the file will be newly created. But you can of course play with that around and see what would be the best option for you. I normally prefer this method. Yeah. So in GN4 there is the so-called G4 analysis manager included, and this is a singleton, so we can write G4 manager instance. Yeah, more we don't need to write, and this we can do in every function where we need it. This is quite advantage. So we can write here man open file, and the name of the output file should be, for example, output.root. Of course, you can also name it different. And when you open that, you also have to close it. So we can write it here already. Here we have to write close file. But before we close it, we have to write it out. This is very important because these root files are very sensitive. If you are not writing them out before you're closing them, or if you forgot to close them or whatsoever, they get quite severely damaged, so you cannot recover them. So this is very important that you use write before. Okay, now we also have to include this class here in our header function. And in this case, the include file is named a little bit different, and it's called g4root.hh. So these are some built-in functions of root, but standalone in GN4. This has the advantage that you don't need to include any root dependency, which makes your program maybe more unstable. Or when you want to have some multi-threading, it gets not thread safe and so on. So it's better to use the built-in function of GN4. And this is in this case g4root, and this includes the class g4 analysis manager. Yeah. So in principle, this should be everything, and we can start, or we can compile our program to see whether it still works, and still there is no error message. So now we have to think what kind of information we want to store. So we have to create the n-tuple or the tree inside this output file. So we have to write it, of course, after that, and we have to write man create n-tuple. So this will be one n-tuple which we create, and we can maybe just call it hits. Of course, you can also give any other name, whatever you want. And then you have to, so these are basically rows which are created, and now we want to fill columns, or we want to give names to our columns. And there we have to write create n-tuple I column. This I stands for integer. Yeah? So let's suppose we want to write the event number out. Yeah? Which hits are related to which event. So we have to write the event number also out. And this we will do, of course, with an integer, because the event number is an integer. But the same we can do also three times more. And in this case, for the coordinates where our detector fired. So we can either write maybe the detector number out, which would be the easiest way, but you can also maybe directly write the information XYZ out. So the position of the detector, which makes analysis a little bit easier later. You don't have to make your mapping or something like that. Yeah, so then we can write, and then finally, these are the information which we want to store now. And then finally, we have to write finish an tuple and then zero, because this is the n tuple number zero that we created. Of course, we can create much more, so we can create another n tuple with some columns, and then we have to finish n tuple one, we have another one, n tuple two, and so on. But for the time being, I think it's perfectly okay if we do it only once, and then the rest you can try maybe as a homework. Okay, yeah, but now we could try this already, but it will not show anything because we have only created the class, but we have not included them in our GN4 program. And for that, we have to go to our action initialization. So we call it maybe here action.hh, action.cc, which we have created previously. And there in our header file, of course, we have to include our run.hh that we newly created. And then we have to go below our generator here and write my run action, and then we call it maybe just run action, new my run action, and then the same as above, set user action run action. Yeah, so now we don't use any default run action implemented in GN4, but we created our own one, and we want to tell now GN4 with that we use our own one. So we can just do it in such a way, and from the class from where it derives from the class from where it is derived, GN4 knows then what it is. Okay, so fine, then we can again compile it now to see whether it worked or whether there is any error message. And currently it looks still good. Of course, we changed something in the header file here, so maybe some more files have to be compiled. And we can run it. And we can maybe create one particle only for fun. Okay, still everything works. And now we can take a look in our output folder. I mean, in our build folder, sorry. We find now this file output.root. And now we can open this with tbrowser. So as I said, you should also maybe take a look at my root tutorials if you want to really go deeper into that. And then we have our hits tree. And then we have our columns. And they are not showing anything exactly how we expect, because we didn't fill it with life until now. And this we will do in the next step. So we have to go back to our sensitive detector class, which we created here. And then we have to basically include here, first of all, because we want to use the analysis manager again. So here we have to write g4 root.hh, and here then we go maybe below that line, and we write again here g4 analysis manager, new g4 analysis manager instance, because as I said, it's a singleton, we can just take it again. And then we can write man fill n tuple I column. So fill n tuple, now we fill the created columns. And yeah, the first one, as I said, should be event number, so we can just call it evt, and the event number then we will take later. I will explain how to get access to that. And the other ones are easy. Here we can write fill n tuple d column, because as I said, we created maybe this I should clarify again. So here it's wrong, it should not be I column, it should be d column, because d for double. And of course the x, y, and z are not integers, they are doubles, so we have to write it in such a way. And here we have to write fill n tuple d column, and then number one will be pos detector zero, which we can take from here where we have previously defined, and it's a g4 3 vector. And the same we have to do then here, and this time it will be 2 and 3, so they are numerical order. Yeah? So it's also important that later when you change something here and you add another column, then you also have to take care that here the numbers are changed according to that, otherwise it will create problems. So, and the last thing which we have to do here is write add n tuple row 0, because it's the zeros n tuple, and yeah, then finish. So every time when when a photon hits our sensor, this class is basically activated and stores then the information of the photon. In our terminal it will show the position, and also then it will store it in the root file. But the EVT, the event number, we also want to get access to, right? And for that we can maybe write here above g for int, it should be an integer, EVT, and then we can use the g for run manager, and from that we can get the current event. And from that we can got the current event ID. This is the simplest way, I think, which you can use. And for that we need another header file, and this is the g4 run manager. So we can write here include dot edge, and now it should be complete finally. Let's hope that there is no spelling mistake. But it is. Yeah, the reason for that is because here there has to be not a new, and here I forgot this. So now again, once more, we can try it. And I guess now it should work. Yeah. So now we will start our simulation program. And of course, with only one event, we will not see so much. So let's directly create 10 events. So we will write run beam on 10. The display is a little bit slow, but here you can see very nicely that the output was okay. And now we have to write root output dot root. And then we have to take a look at our hits n tuple, and if we press or if we click on the first branch that is here shown, F event, we can see the number of entries in total, 6,225 divided by 10, because we created 10 events, means that in principle something like 620 photons are registered per event, which is quite, one can also cross check this here, and I think this is quite a good value and matching with theoretical predictions. However, you can see some high fluctuations here. It's because we are not starting from zero. We are starting here from the lowest entry, 570. So we can right click on that, click on set range user, and then maybe go from 0 to 700. And now you can see that it gets quite uniform. Now some statistical fluctuations in any case, but it's still quite uniform. Okay, and now we can take a look at, this is the event number basically here, and the number of entries. So now we can go one step further and have a look at the X distribution of the hit sensors. And yeah, it looks, I think, more or less how you expect it, because at the end you expect a circle. So, and the sides, the projection of this in the X coordinate, you get a higher amounts here on the sides and smaller amounts in the center. The same for the Y direction, and here you have a outlier. And for Z, you of course expect only a single value, a delta function more or less, which is the upper position of the detector. Okay, perfect. So this is okay. And now let's have a look whether the results are consistent. So we want to make a correlation now between X and Y. So we can write hits draw, and now we have to write fx double dot fy. So fx against fy, or fx versus fy. Then we don't want to apply any condition, but we want to draw it in color. So we have to write as a draw option call Z. And now we have a look, and I think you can see very clearly here this nice ring pattern from our Cherenkov cone that has been created. So exactly what you expect. And also you can see the number of entries here if you are interested in that. So you can do really nice things. I recommend to write then always an external root script which analyzes your data after simulating them. It has the advantage that you have your programs a little bit separated. One program is for simulation and one is for analysis. But of course you can also insert everything directly into GN4. And when you get the output result, you have already the analyzed value. So you can make a fit, for example, a Riemann fit to get to reconstruct the Cherenkov angle from that and so on. Maybe I will go into detail later about this, but still there are many other topics which I want to cover. For example, how to insert multithreading, how to insert messengers to make sure that the geometry can be changed during runs and so on. Nevertheless, I think now we are on a stage where we have a complete program that can be used for other purposes also. So whatever kind of detector you can imagine and that you want to construct, you can do that now with the knowledge which you have, and you should really try it. Maybe you can make your own detector, maybe you can try to create a calorimeter or some cosmic showers or something like that. And it would be also nice if you tell me then what kind of experience you have regarding that in the comment section, so I can also learn something from that maybe. And if you have any further ideas what I can do, please also write it into the comment section. And I think then next week I will have some time to continue with the next lecture. Okay, I hope you enjoyed it and you learned something as usual, and also that you can use it. And I promise, as I said, that I will try to take care of all other comments also and implement them. And yeah, okay. So, if you like it, please subscribe as usual, and then I would say see you next time.